So here's the basic setup that we're going to need for this lab. We got a ruler, our pair of tweezers that should be in your drawer. We got one of our TLC plates. That's this glass plate with the silica gel absorbed on it. See, it's really thin, hence the name thin layer. You got one side that's got the silica. The other side is a glass back. You can see the reflections there. So you're going to be doing all of your work on this silica gel side. Pencil to write on that, a filter paper wick. We've got our TLC solvent back there. That's that 15 to 10 to 1 mixture that was mentioned in the PowerPoints. We've got our 400 mil beaker with a foil lid on top. You can see that's kind of fitting nicely on top there like a cap. Our microcapillaries, and these are just really tiny little glass tubes. You can see really thin, open on both ends, and those will be found in a container that looks like this. And we've also got four vials. Three of those contain the standards, aspirin dissolved in methanol, acetaminophen dissolved in methanol, and caffeine dissolved in methanol. All three of those should be liquids already. They should be solutions that you should be able to get from the reagent hood. And then you're actually going to take some of your unknown drug mixture and dissolve that in methanol yourself. So all the markings that we make need to be in pencil. If you make markings in pen, then all the dyes and binders and everything that are in that ink are going to separate out and make a mess on your plate. So make sure you use pencil, which is made of graphite. Since we're spotting four different things, we're going to need to make four different lanes on this TLC plate. So I'm going to start out by drawing the baseline at the bottom. When you make this baseline, you want to make it far enough off the bottom that you can comfortably put this down into a solution without having the solution come over this line. So I'm going to come up, maybe a centimeter or so, and draw a line straight across there. So that line is going to be where I start spotting all of my compounds. Once I've got this line, I want to make four different tick marks for the four different materials that I'm going to be spotting on here. And when you're writing on here, you want to be careful not to push too hard, because if you push too hard with that pencil, you're actually going to etch the silica gel off the plate. So be careful when you're marking on that plate. Now I'm actually going to spot the material that I want to run on this plate onto the baseline that I just laid out. So I've got my unknown, I've got my aspirin, my acetaminophen, and the caffeine over there on the far right, which match up to the four lanes. So now I want to spot these on using the microcapillaries that I mentioned. So those microcapillaries, really tiny, look like this. You're going to take that capillary and then dip it into the vial containing, in the first row, our unknown. So what I'm going to do is take that in, pick up a little bit of the liquid that's in there, and you can see that's in the tip there, and then I'm going to spot that on the hash mark for the unknown. So as soon as I put that down, the liquid is going to draw down to the plate. One thing that you have to be kind of aware of is the amount of material you put on there. Is that going to be enough or too much so that you're not going to be able to see it if it's not enough? Or if it's too much, then it's going to be just overloading the plate and make it difficult to run smoothly up. So if you're curious to see if you put enough on there, what you want to do is take this plate, so I've just put that unknown on there, and then come over to the UV and then actually check to see if that plate is absorbing on that spot. And it's kind of difficult to see from that distance, but you can actually see a dark spot right there on that first lane. So that means I've spotted enough on there to get a visualization on this once I get done with the TLC run. So you can do that with each of your spots to make sure you've spotted them. Alright, so now we're going to, first of all, take our beaker and fill it up with the developing solvent. So I want to remove this foil cap for a second, and then the TLC solvent we're using, you can see, has a label that has 15 parts ethylacetate, 10 parts hexanes, and 1 part glacial acetic acid. So we'll take the cap off this, and then we only need enough in the bottom of this beaker to just cover the bottom. So we don't need to fill this up. We just need enough in there to cover the bottom for running the TLC plate. Also, you'll need your filter paper. Kind of dip that down in the solvent, and then let the solvent kind of travel up that filter paper so that it adheres to the wall of the beaker. Once you do that, you're going to want to close up the top. So now, as you can see, I've got my cap on, beaker filled with solvent, and then the filter paper wick on the side. So at this point, while we're giving it a minute, that chamber is filling up with the vapor from our solvent. Because when we put our TLC plate in there, we're going to put this plate down in the solvent, and the solvent's going to start to rise up. If we have a situation where we don't have a cap on the top, then as this solvent rises up by capillary action, it's going to continually evaporate. So instead of running up nicely, it's going to run up and evaporate and run back down and up and evaporate. So we want to make sure that this system has a consistent level of vapors all the way through. So now that the vapors have filled up, we're going to take our plate. You can use your tweezers at this point. Open up the foil cap. Make sure the plate doesn't touch that filter paper wick, but drop that down inside and put the cap right back on top. So at this point, it's traveled an acceptable distance up the plate. I'm going to open the cap, pull the plate out, and then where that solvent line is, I'm going to draw a line with my pencil so you can see. We started down here, and the solvent finished right up here at the top. So at this point, we're going to let the plate dry for a second and then subject it to visualization. So on this plate, we've got, and it's a little difficult to see, you can probably see a little bit of it. Here's our three standards. So we got a spot right here for caffeine, spot for acetaminophen, and then aspirin. And then we've got our unknown mixture over here on the side. So while these are under the light, I'm going to take the pencil and circle all these spots. Make sure you circle all the spots before you turn off the UV light or go away from the UV light. So this time we can go ahead and put this plate into the iodine chamber, use the longer forceps to put that down inside gently. Make sure to always keep this iodine chamber in the hood, as there's some fumes that come out of it that we don't want to breathe. You'll just want to leave it inside there for a good 30, 45 seconds at least, or until you start seeing some yellow spots on your plate. So as we take this out of the iodine chamber, we'll see a couple spots here, yellow spots that we want to go ahead and make sure you notate that those spots have iodine stain, and just mark that as an iodine stain. And it appears also this spot has a slight iodine stain. So I put little eyes on there to just denote that it stains by iodine as well as UV. So at this point, we've got all of our spots there, and we want to calculate the RFs by getting the distance in centimeters from the baseline to the middle of the spot divided by the distance from the baseline to the solvent front. So get all those RFs for all the spots on your plate, and you should be ready to do your discussion and results section.